Hello and welcome to Let's Explore Bard's Tale 3, and this will be part 4. Last episode we went through onto way level 2 and reached the staircase. A very simple riddle was blocking our passage. Oh, it wasn't blocking because we solved the riddle. But return from beyond this place is not possible by this means. It's probably an indication that this could be a one-way staircase. But let's proceed. Oh, the spectral hand of fear runs bony fingers down your spine. The air is hot and close. The place feels like the inside of a grave. Interesting. Unless, of course, the door behind us is... Oh, the passage is turned into a wall that we can't face through on the above level. Oh well, no. Okay, that looks pleasant. Huge sloth. You know what? You can start off. There's a trap. We should probably trap up. If I can detect it, I can breach it. So, okay, okay. There's a trap near the spell's waiver. There's something special near. You take detect movement ahead. This is lovely. Let's just quick save because I'm a coward. So, time to make use of the quick save. This path here leading down to the square box down here is filled with crap. We have an encounter square, guaranteed encounter square here. Which I may be able to get around. Regardless. Antimatic down here. Mana point, spell points drain as well. There's health draining squares in here and spinners. And of course darkness and yeah, a lot of good stuff. This game will like sometimes to throw something very, very nasty at you. Demon Gary Lord, can we run away from this? We can, but we're losing our spell points now. And in darkness. So, this should be a spinner. Okay. We got rid of those traps. We're not in an antimatic square. You know, we are relatively safe here, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to risk quick saving. It quick saves in 3 different slots. So, nice of it, I'd say. Run away. If you haven't got the compass, the minimap turns around, which I find rather annoying. I should probably do that. Let's look. That. Okay. I don't need to map these squares out there because these are identical to this. Magic chain is a feeling of malevolence, something in draining our spell points. Well, these two are draining health instead. Whatever the case, it's the naughty, so we are in need of getting. Come on, this way. Oh, spell points drain because that's fun. May as well spend the mana while we've got it, so the spell points even. Haha, we can disarm traps through walls. So, where are we? I'm fairly sure there's 4 levels in this, but I could be mistaken, could be this 3. Because that area seems very, very familiar to what I remember from years ago. I could be mistaken, but you know, let's head in one direction at a time. To take movement ahead. Movement ahead. Go away. Apparently not. Nope. Tag, you can hide in shadows. Let's see if we can see what these do. Yeah, good luck hitting my monk. She is not hard, she's not easy to hit in melee. Something special near. The spells available to this item, of course, yeah. Marrow Sucker, screw up to this Venom Claws and Bone Acolyte. You know what? We're just going to do our good old classic. How are we looking? We're looking okay. Why not? Just in case. Never know what you get thrown at you, so having anti-magic from time to time, it doesn't reduce damage, but increases the chance of you repelling even the magic damage. So just make sure. Some of the casters are very sensitive to mind jab, others of them are not. Yeah. A soul maze, unidentified weapon. Okay, let's find out what is a soul maze. Should probably get my rogue to see if he can identify the unidentified weapon. War staff. Cool. Is that any good for him? It's one thing I like is it lists the difference in damage compared to what you currently have equipped. You can see minimum and maximum damage down by 2 and 3 respectively, but 1 is a bonus to hit. It is just not worth it though. War staff. Nah, we'll probably just scrap it. There's no, as far as I know, no stores you can vendor stuff at, so it's completely relevant to even consider. Go away, I don't want to fight. I know I can do something about that. Sathnia, of course, yeah. Okay, that was your light ignites the gas in the area. Why not? That's what you get for exploring, but I like exploring. That's the purpose of playing this or making this video series, is to explore. So, I don't know why I still want to map these levels, because some of them are painful, as probably noticed by now. Movement, of course. A feeling of malevolence, that wouldn't be... Aha, malevolence, wow. What are we affected by at the moment? A feeling of malevolence, lovely. What does that entail? It's probably... probably negative for combat if we end up fighting that. We will do the usual. Nope, not mobble, but middle. I can actually remember most four-letter codes for these spells. Dann weiter. You hide in the shadow. See what we can do with this. Okie dokie. Fight. A. B. Defend. What kind of magic would they be vulnerable to? You can actually get that information through the bestiary. Let's try and throw a dragon breath at them. Oops. You see what they say to that? They may not care. Nah. Yeah. I don't really impressed by that. Okay, that's gone. I have to be careful, just noticed my health is quite low. You know what? Let's see what they say to code instead and restoration. Yeah. Oh, didn't seem to care much about that either. They are now at 20 feet. Let's just attack in thin air in case they decide to move forward and then use the fire horn. Ah, they didn't care about that at all. Okay. Killer never. Does that mean they can do critical hits? I wouldn't be surprised. Obviously, they have to hit, but if they hit, they might kill. And I haven't got any ways of any kind to raise the dead even. There's no temples left because Mangard destroyed them all. Dragon Tarjan destroyed them. So until you get access to a certain spell called Grave Robber. You can't get people raised from the dead. So, that looks encouraging. I'm just going to quick save. So that's what it is. Okay. I suppose. I mean, why not? Go away. Don't want to fight you. I meant to do this. Aha. A figure appears and asks, I have no lips, yet my kiss is deadly. I am not a razor, but those I caress need never shave again. Your best friend, I will kill you. That villain sounds familiar. That wouldn't be. Speak my name, then Vedini. That sounds like, but. Very good, you may be well suited to battle. You have the touch after all. Is it just me that that little seem a bit odd? Maybe. I don't know. Well, I got the squares mapped. It was painful, but I got them mapped. That was the whole purpose. So that will be some entry kind of way. Let's Just analyze that for a second. I have no lips, yet my kiss is deadly. I'm not a razor, but those I caress need never shave again. Yes, Bruce, I mean... Whatever works. Only a fool would frontally assault the second ward. I'm a fool. Go away. That's not nice. Stop breathing in my body. I want to run away. That's an interesting hint, isn't it? Only a fool would frontally assault the second ward. You see, when you have one of those, go away. When you have one of those incidents where things go wrong and you suddenly need to edit out 5 minutes or 6 minutes, whatever, when you're trying to make a predefined video length, go away. It becomes quite wonky because you have to work out just roughly how much time you need to add to the videos in order to end up with that time you are gunning for. Nope, not done. Come on. Something tells me this dungeon is not an awful lot wider or larger, awful lot bigger than what is currently being seen. By the way, something that's worth mentioning, when you are at the bottom or the top, facing the top or facing the bottom, any detection spells will loop around. So let's say you are standing here facing south, and there's a trap here, you will detect that trap because the map is basically a wrap. So sometimes, initially when I start playing this, I was a bit confused. There's a trap nearby, there's no traps nearby. That should be enough spell points. Let's see what's in here. There's a trap near. Poof, no longer. Something special near. Oh. Nice. The thing is, of course, once you've mapped everything, you could just write all the numbers down. You could play a new game and then teleport, 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 encounter, 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 and probably be done with certain areas in a very, very short time. So, let's quick save and see what this brings. Yeah, something special near, you don't say. That gas thing, oops. Oh, we got it cleared, I suppose. I mean, that's one way of doing it. Yeah, as you can see it if you look here. That's why we got the riddle, so it loops around. So, what do we want to explore first? Something tells me this is just going to be one huge square of darkness, anti-magic, all sorts of good stuff. The game can really like throwing that stuff at you, but the whole purpose, I'm not going to repeat that every single time I make a new episode, but the whole purpose of this is to map every single square. Go away, don't want to fight. Collapse up. So, should probably do this. I have a feeling this could be a naughty. No way. Nothing here. Something special in here. Facing north. Away. Okay. So that one. detect movement ahead. Five Venom Claws. No, I don't want to fight you. What's that? And why are those some of them capitalized? Might be. Of course, at north, east, east, south, south, east, 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 north, north, west, north, north, west, west. Never now ever seen it leaves a narrow north by northwest way those mourn. Wards? That sounds interesting. I have to admit that does not ring a bell from the olden days. Intriguing. Have I stumbled into something I wasn't previously aware of? That wouldn't be surprising and as I mentioned, and I can mention again, that is the purpose of this video series, to work out what has been missed. Oops, I forgot I was a bit low health. It's fine. Nope, I want to get rid of that bone acolyte, and mind jabs are usually quite good at doing that. Amisha. Nope. Another starfire. Fight, defend. By the way, I know it says it has a ranged option, and that is the axe is actually swinging at the moment, the Chaos Axe. This could be dicey. Storm is not always my fastest caster, but hopefully she will get her thing out, because if that Starflare comes off, my monk might be... Oh, here it comes. How nice of him. Wineskin. Wineskin contains liquids which are used by the bard to refresh his voice. It's probably a bit of an odd point, but... minus editing and all that stuff, I think we are on a good time to end the spot. So I will say thanks for watching. Next time we will be mapping the rest of this area and see what those wards are about. It could just be a red herring. It could just make you think that something is afoot, which is not afoot. That wouldn't be surprising for this game. So, as I said, thanks for watching. Take care. See you next time. Bye bye for now.